Just Rabbit here on Classic Rock The Vault with Steve from Kix. Steve, you want to tell us a little bit about how Kix started?
No.
Please?
That's a long time ago. Too many years and too many beers. In a nutshell, these guys came and fished me out of a little town in West Virginia because they had a vision and goals to get a record deal. So when they invited me to be a part of it, we just put our noses to the grindstone and we worked our tails off. We worked all the time. We played every opportunity we had until we built a nice big following in the area. Then it branched out into the Baltimore, D.C. area. Then it branched out into the New York and Boston area. So we just were relentless in bringing crowds in and getting noticed. So finally, record labels started to catch wind of what we were doing and started snipping at our heels. And eventually we signed with Atlantic Records.
Now, how long have you and Kix been together?
The band started in like 1977, and I was not the original singer. They came and got me around the end of the fall of 1978, so they were around for about a year and a half before they got me in the band. So since around 1978 with this lineup.
In your time of playing with them, what is your most favorite song that you guys have done?
The most favorite song? You know, every time you write an album, that album is your favorite album. When you write a song, that song is your favorite song. So, after a while, though, they all just kind of run together because you play them so much.
I grew up listening to you guys, so this is just, you know, a wild thing for me to be able to do this interview, you know, because I do a lot of DJing, too, and I play a good bit of your music.
Nice to hear.
Talk a little bit about yourself and the band.
Well, right now, we just feel blessed that we're kind of back into doing what we love to do. We had a 10-year hiatus after like 1995. We put out our last studio album, and the times were changing. There was a new party in town, and we just weren't invited, so we knew that it was time for us to call it quits and move on. So we took about a 10-year hiatus, and little by little, we just kept getting calls about coming back and doing a show here and doing a show there. And eventually it led to getting a national agent to where we're playing like 30, 40 dates a year again. So it's all different now. It's changed. It's not hopping a van or hopping a bus and pound the pavements for a year. It's book a date for the weekend, book a festival, book a casino, leave the day before, play the show, come back the next day. So it's called fly dates now. So it's a whole new ball game. And we just put out a new album last August. And again, it was just all done entirely different. No big studios are necessary anymore. No big waste of money. Record labels are hardly even needed anymore. But our last album was called, the hell's it called? Rock Your Face Off. So that's still available on iTunes and Amazon and all that good stuff. The people who thought we hadn't put anything out in 20 years, that's out there. And in the meantime, we've just been playing all over the country. That's what we've been doing, playing in the area once in a while, but for the most part, playing like Salt Lake City and Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. We played not too long ago, Greensburg, PA, Florida, all over the place. I can't even remember all the places we've been to, New Jersey, North Dakota. So that's what we do now. We just we do more fly dates than anything.
Okay. Do you want to talk a little bit about your upcoming event, December 18th?
Yeah. Brunswick Fire Hall has become an annual for us. We know the people very well over there. It's always a great time. It's always a big crowd. It helps the fire company. It helps the community. It's a great local gig for us, so it's a win-win for everybody. So we all look forward to it, and every year it seems to get bigger and bigger. So once again, always fun and looking forward to it.
I like that you guys go in and do stuff for the fire department. I've retired volunteer firefighter in EMS I've done it for 20 some years and just retired about 5 years ago. So when I seen it,
nice,
you did this, that you guys are doing this one, that it was like, wow, that's just awesome that you guys give and do that with the fire department.
Well, it's just the perfect opportunity. It's not like we can do it all over the country, but for that particular situation, it works really well. And there's another situation up in Humblestown, Pennsylvania. We do the same thing. Fire company puts on the event. It draws a huge crowd. It helps them. helps the community, and we love doing it.
Do you want to let our listeners know where they can purchase the tickets at? You know that
That's
information.
Good question. I don't know.
Okay. I know we have
a fire hall. I will go onto the website, Brunswick Fire Hall, and I'm sure that would lead you.
Yeah, because I know we have it posted on Classic Rock the Vault. So if you were looking for that information, go on Classic Rock the Vault, and you can find that information on how to purchase the tickets. I know that I, myself, and Mike Wolf will get to be down there with you guys, and I'm excited about that.
Cool. Maybe you guys can bring us on when you guys want to get up and bring us on.
That would be an honor. We really enjoy that and appreciate that.
Yeah.
Do you have any other upcoming events that you want to talk about other than December 18th?
Yeah, I mean, the night after we play the Brunswick Fire Hall, we're doing one of our favorite rooms in the area down in Baltimore called Ram's Head Live, and that's just always, it's humongous crowd, loudest crowd on earth. The Baltimore people were just, they embraced us years ago, and they've never stopped embracing us. And then in January, we just got the call that we were invited to do the Def Leppard Cruise, which is, it's Def Leppard playing and several other bands playing in between, and we're honored to be doing something like that. So we're doing that at the end of January. And we just keep trucking on. We do Monsters of Rock cruises. We do M3. We do, people think we only play around in the area once in a while, but we're playing all over the country again. So it's great to be back in the party.
That is awesome. I know I am thrilled that you guys are back in the rotation because, like I said, I grew up listening to you guys. So did my kids. You know, I made them listen to you guys and Death Leopard and all them. Yep. And I tell you what really shocks me is when I go do parties and kids are asking for the kind of music that I grew up listening to. So,
good music doesn't go away. I mean, if it stands the test of time, like my kids, I brought them upright and turned them on to good classic rock and roll. Now, they still like some of their new music, but they appreciate the roots that I shared with them. So if it's good, it stays good.
The one thing I like and I tell my kids about classic rock music and rock is that it speaks to you. It's coming from something of an experience and stuff. Because today, to me, today's music don't really do a lot of speaking like the music that I grew up to listening to.
There are some out there. They're few and far between, but I agree with you for the most part. But there are some bands. If you look around hard enough, and I'm lucky enough that my kids turn me on to some new bands once in a while that I really like. So they are there. You just got to find them.
Yeah, being a DJ, you get to know all kinds of varieties of music because I play anywhere from, rap down to country, the whole nine yards I get to do. But I'm do a weekend or a week and I get to come back in my studio and do the classic rock. I call that my refreshing time.
Yeah, I don't think you ever get tired of or let go of the music that you grew up with. I mean, I was a child of the 70s and I still love those bands of the 70s, Kiss and Aerosmith and James Gang, Deep Purple, Led Zeppelin. Those are the bands that inspired me, and that's still, to this day, my favorite music.
And having my kids raise their kids doing the same thing and letting them see all kinds of music, it's just a wonderful thing to see them enjoy the music that I enjoyed.
Yep.
Let's talk a little bit about your band members. You want to let everybody know about who's in your band and stuff?
I think everybody knows who's in our band, but I'll tell you anyway. Most of us are from the area. Right now, Brian Forsythe used to live in the area, now lives in Los Angeles, so every time we play somewhere, we have to fly him in, or he flies to all the other places that we play by himself usually. Jimmy Chalfont lives in Shepherdstown now with his wife, and Ronnie Yonkins, Ronnie 1010, lives in Myersville. I'm still in Hagerstown, and our new bass player, Mark Shanker, lives in Virginia, Northern Virginia. So most of us are pretty much still in the area other than Brian.
I know when some of the people seen on the Just Rabbit Facebook and stuff that I was doing an interview with you guys, they were like, oh, they're my, we follow them. We have every record and stuff. And, that's so exciting that you could be able to do that. And I was like, yeah, I'm really thrilled about doing it too. And I just want to make sure that, we cover all the bases for all of our listeners of what they want to, hear from you. Do you got
sure.
other anything else that you want to share?
No, just all the years and all the support and the fans that have stuck with us over the years, we truly appreciate them and love them, and as long as we keep going the way we're going, everybody still feels good, looks good, rocks good. As long as we're able to keep doing this and the people want to see it, we're into it.
The one thing I do say, and I tell everybody this, even with my DJing and stuff, I said, You know, when it becomes not about the listeners and about the people that support us, I don't like to be the heavy head. Is that what I'm probably saying? And I get that sense from you that, you know, you really appreciate the people that support you.
You have to. You wouldn't be here without them.
That's right.
You have to remember that. If you think it's about you, then you're in the wrong business.
That's right. And I'm enjoying this interview with you. And is there any other areas that you want to hit upon?
No, I think we've covered just about everything.
See, it wasn't that bad. It wasn't that painful.
No, not at all.